Good evening. Glad you could tune in to another What's Your Point? We've got kind of a theme show lined up for you this evening. Some bright young academics all prepared to share their non-expert opinions and make their point. It all starts right now. It is kind of post-secondary education night on What's Your Point? Let me introduce you now to these Conestoga College students in this corner. We have Matthew Trushinski. Over here, Carrie Gilmour. And Jelena Jenko. And say hello to Jamie Zadow. Those are the guests. Now, let's have a look at the first topic.
This from the U.S., where a growing number of female college students are making thousands of dollars selling their eggs to infertile couples. It's a $38 million a year business. The best colleges have become hunting grounds for infertile couples looking for smart, attractive women to sell their eggs. Prices can range from $5,000 to $20,000. Of course, this raises some medical and a lot of ethical questions, but how would you feel about graduating with no student debt?
So before we get to our guests, let's see how some students at the University of Guelph reacted to this story. Girls in U.S. colleges are raising money by selling their eggs to infertile couples.
Really?
And we're just wondering whether or not you think that's a good idea or not.
I think it's a good idea.
I don't know. That's almost seems like that's kind of one of those issues that you just really wouldn't see. I don't know if you necessarily consider that really an appropriate thing for them to do.
It's a little just weird.
Yeah.
I know that definitely for young women, we have a lot of difficulties trying to figure out how to get through school, and there's always different ways that we try and get through school.
Your egg's a pretty good deal, though.
We've got lots of eggs, you know.
What would you charge? What do you think the going price would be?
Maybe a couple hundred dollars, maybe.
They're getting $10,000, $15,000, $20,000. Would that change your mind?
That definitely changed my mind, yeah.
It seemed, you know, a lot of the guys, when I asked them, said, no, I don't think it's a good idea. When you mentioned the cash, just about everybody said, who changed their mind, and said, yeah, that's a pretty good idea. Anyway, Matthew, you start.
Well, that's the thing, right? You got to consider just how much students are in debt when they come out of school. And if they're willing to do something like sell their eggs to pay off that debt, I mean, that says something about...
Well, like the girl said, there's lots of eggs.
I don't know. I'm against this. I don't know if I'd want my eggs being purchased by someone and they're going to reproduce with my eggs. I just don't feel comfortable with that.
It's such a good cause, though.
Well, personally, I mean, I'm not a girl, but if I was in the position, it's a way to pay off school, right? I mean, if you're earning 20 grand for
I completely agree. Like, I've got, I mean, I'm sure I've got tons of them, I hope, but I've never really checked, but I'm not planning to have that many children, so I figure why not make money if I could, and school's
pretty expensive.
But you get
into school knowing that you're going to have a student debt.
Oh, I completely understand that.
To come out by selling a part of you, I don't know.
These couples are willing to spend $20,000 on an egg. I mean, these are people that are probably pretty serious about giving that child a good life, providing for it. If they're willing to spend that much money just to have a baby, odds are they're going to take care of that baby. The baby's going to have a good life. And
it's a personal choice, right? These women that they're preying on are smart, intellectual women, and I just kind of question how smart they really are if they're selling their eggs.
Well, I mean, it's going to a good cause, right? Like, I mean, as Matt was saying, I mean, I'm sure the people who are purchasing the eggs want to give a good lifestyle for their
You see a little Jamie walking around one day and you're like, wow, he really looks like me, but I got 10 grand that I blew on school and drinking or whatever.
It's just Jamie's part of him, though.
It's his DNA.
I mean, I guess that just depends on your definition of what a child is, if it's more biological or if it's the upbringing.
Okay, well then, what about this? They are going to the colleges and maybe even look at the female's grade point average. They're not going to the slums and saying, what about you selling me? So what are you looking at here? Some kind of super race? A more intelligent race.
That is it, yeah.
Well, take a look at it. That's what they're doing. They're going to the colleges.
Why not more intelligent? Like, if you have a choice between more intelligent women that are maybe more genetically predisposed to, I don't know, having children that are actually smarter and more intelligent than white.
So are they now going to start looking for blonde hair, blue eyes, smart?
I believe actually that's exactly what they're doing. Anyway, good discussion. And of course, it is time now to reward tonight's guest that did the best job of making their point. Here's the winning comment as selected by our panel of editorial judges.
Personally, I mean, I'm not a girl, but if I was in the position, it's a way to pay off school, right?
Okay, terrific.
Great.
Who are you going to give the money to?
The Grand River Hospital Cancer Center.
All right, terrific. We'll write them a check and send it along. Okay, let's find out what everybody is doing. Matthew Brzezinski.
Yep. Well, like everyone else here, I'm first year journalism broadcast at Conestoga College. I have history at University of Guelph. I was pursuing an English degree there, but I switched over to this journalism program and I like it a lot better.
All right.
I'm from Walkerton, up north. So this is like the second city I lived in besides Guelph, and really love the region.
Okay, terrific. All right, and Carrie Gilmour.
Hi, I'm a mentor for Big Brothers and Big Sisters of Kitchener, and I also work on their newsletter, and I'm looking forward to ice skating at City Hall.
Okay, and Jelena Jenko.
Hi, again, I'm a Conestoga College student, first year. This is my first year of post-secondary, and the thing I'm most looking forward to is reading week, so I can have some fun and not read.
And Jamie, our winner, Zadow.
Yeah, I also am in the same class as these guys at Conestoga, broadcast journalism, and first time on the show, great to be here. And yeah.
You know what, y'all did a great job. Thanks a lot for stopping by. We'll have you on again, maybe in the future. Thank you for watching out there. We are back next week with more of What's Your Point? We'll see you then. Say hi to Mom and Dad then.